25 pages. That coming from the lawyer for the founder of Fusion GPS. That is the firm that is behind the dossier. In testimony released today by Dianne Feinstein of the Senate Judiciary Committee against the strong objection of Republicans, we learned that, quote, somebody's already been killed as a result of the publication of this dossier. This testimony coming as we are learning the former British spy who authored the dossier felt obligated to inform the FBI because he was afraid Trump was being blackmailed by the Russians. Obligated to call the FBI out of duty because he feared a candidate for president of the United States was being blackmailed by Russians. Now, all of this, what you've just heard, does not fit with the narrative that the president and his allies want Americans to believe.
I think it's very sad what they've done with this fake dossier. It was made up, and I understand they paid a tremendous amount of money. And Hillary Clinton always denied it. The Democrats always denied it.
They put a lot of BS in this thing, fake news, and they tried to dress it up as an intelligence product.
Everyone knows this dossier is garbage.
Senators,
but did they
Warner
dress it up
Burr
like intelligence?
Fake, BS, garbage. Yet someone may have been killed because of the dossier? At least 9 high-profile Russians died in the 9 months after the American presidential election, including a former Russian intelligence official who had close ties to figures mentioned in the dossier. Could the person possibly killed because of the dossier be Oleg Erivinkin, who was found dead shortly after news of the dossier broke, sitting in the back of his car on the streets of Moscow? He was a former general in Russia's spy agency. As former FBI agent Clint Watts testified to Congress, the truth can be found if you know the trail to follow.
Follow the trail of dead Russians. There's been more dead Russians in the past 3 months that are tied to this investigation who have assets and banks all over the world.
There's one thing for sure tonight. We need to know what is true and what is not true in this dossier. The president and his allies are wrong. It is not all garbage. As we've reported, as an example, we know that some of the conversations reported in this dossier between non-Americans did, in fact, occur as reported in the dossier. What matters is not to try to politicize this document, as Republicans have done. What matters is to separate the truth from fiction and find out what really happened. Manu Raju begins our coverage out front tonight. And Manu, the transcript of the testimony, 312 pages, pokes major holes in the GOP talking points, calling the dossier garbage.
Yeah, the co-founder of that firm, Fusion GPS, who hired Christopher Steele to investigate, said that they wanted Steele to look into candidate Trump's past, his business dealings, why he went to Russia, because there were some questions that they wanted to learn about exactly what happened. And what Mr. Steele found, according to this transcript, was so alarming that he had to inform the FBI.
The 312-page transcript includes new revelations about the infamous opposition research dossier on Donald Trump and the Russians. Glenn Simpson, the co-founder of the opposition research firm Fusion GPS, told the Senate Judiciary Committee that a former British agent who compiled the dossier was so concerned about what he found that he decided to brief the FBI in the summer of 2016. The agent, Christopher Steele, worried about a security issue about whether a presidential candidate was being blackmailed, according to Simpson's transcript. Simpson also testified that Steele told him the FBI had similar intelligence from an internal Trump campaign source, and that the FBI believed Chris's information might be credible because they had other intelligence that indicated the same thing. And one of those pieces of intelligence was a human source from inside the Trump organization. A person close to Simpson clarified that the reference to an internal Trump campaign source actually refers to the Australian ambassador who contacted the FBI to pass on information that he'd received from former Trump campaign foreign policy advisor George Papadopoulos. Simpson testified the research did not start out as a Russia-focused investigation, but rather was a broader look at his business career, his finances, and they were trying to figure out whether he's really as rich as he says he is. But Simpson later said he was also interested in Russia, and how Trump had made a number of trips to Russia and talked about doing a number of business deals, but never did one. And that struck me as a little bit odd and calling for an explanation.
It's all fake news. It's phony stuff.
The president and his allies from the beginning have said the dossier is fake and full of lies. but Simpson testified that Steele understood that the Russians used disinformation as a common tactic. What he said was disinformation is an issue in my profession, and that we are trained to spot disinformation. I'm telling you that I don't believe this is disinformation. The top Democrat on the committee, Dianne Feinstein, released a transcript despite furious opposition from the committee's GOP chairman, Chuck Grassley, whose spokesman said the unilateral move was totally confounding because it could undercut the inquiry. The move intensified the partisan acrimony on the panel.
I think in some ways this is the signal of the end of bipartisan cooperation in the Senate Judiciary Committee.
Now, during this August interview, Glenn Simpson was asked by the committee about Mr. Steele's sources, and he would not reveal his sources because, according to his attorney, one of those sources may have been killed because of his cooperation with Christopher Steele in putting together the dossier. Now, tonight, a source close to that testimony, Aaron, tells us it wasn't in reference to any individual, but to the string of deaths that occurred in Russia after the elections, raising some concerns about exactly why he would reveal these sources of information, because perhaps that could endanger further lives if they were to get out, Aaron.
All right. Thank you.